हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आज हम देख रहे हैं 15 चैप्टर गवर्नमेंट क्लास 6 सोशल साइंस। ओके, वर्कबुक की एक्सरसाइज देख रहे हैं। ये चैप्टर एक्सप्लेनेशन बाकी है, इसकी वीडियो मैं बाद में बना दूंगी, ठीक है। ओके, द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज चूज द करेक्ट आंसर्स। ये आप डायरेक्टली यहाँ से कॉपी कर लीजिए। ओके, द क्वेश्चन नंबर 2 इज फिलिंग द ब्लैंक्स। देन क्वेश्चन नंबर 3 इज पुट द टिक मार्क, ट्रू और फॉल्स। देन क्वेश्चन नंबर 4 इज मैच द पैर। एक ही मैच द पैर है, ओके। देन द क्वेश्चन नंबर 5 इज आंसर द फॉलोइंग क्वेश्चंस इन वन ऑफ टू सेंटेंसेस। द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज हाउ मेनी टाइप्स ऑफ गवर्नमेंट आर देयर, विच आर दे। देर आर There are three main types of government. First is democratic government, second is communist government or dictatorship and monarchy. Okay. Then second question is which type of government is there in our country? There is a parliamentary democratic governance system in our country. Third question is at what work does a democratic government legally do? A democratic government work as forming or reforming and implementing laws, keeping the constitution in mind in accordance with public opinion. Fourth question is what is democracy? According to the former US President Abraham Lincoln, the system which is run by the people of the people and for the people is called the democratic governance system. Fifth question is at which level does the democratic government work? Democratic government works at the three level, local, as a local self-government, state government and central government. Next page, question number 6 is who governs the government in democracy? In a democracy, the government is governed by direct or indirect voting of the people. Seventh question is why does each country require a government? Each country requires the government to take a different decision from administration and implement those decisions. Yeah, administration ke spelling mein T ke baad R hai, okay? Then 8th question is which are the main function of democratic government? The main function of the democratic government are it forms, implements and reforms laws as well as give us justice. 9th is who governs the entire nation? The central government governs the entire nation. 10th question is how does the communist government administer the government system? The communist government manages the government system on the basis of similarity and equality. 11th question is as of which ideology is communist ideology known in the world? Communist ideology is known in the world as the leftist ideology, that is liberal ideology. 12th is in a monarchy what is given emphasizes? In the monarchy the emphasis is given only on the well-being and convenience of the ruler. Question number 6 is give historical reason for the following statement. First question is people are at the center in democracy. According to the former President Abraham Lincoln, the democratic government means a system which is run by the people of the people and for the people is called democratic governance system. In democracy, people elect their representatives through voting. The government is formed with the representatives to administer the country. That government has to govern the country according to public opinion. If the government does not administer according to the public opinion, people will not delegate the administration of the country in the next election. Thus, since people have sovereignty in the formation of government in democracy, it can be said that people are considered in a center in democracy. Second question is the right of the people are not maintained in a democracy. In a monarchy. In a monarchy rule, the ruler or a king is at the center. The position of the king is inherited in a monarchy. In a monarchy, people do not have the right to choose their rulers. In a monarchy, all power is in the hand of the king. The king's desire become the law. The decisions taken by the king are considered as the final. Therefore, the rights of the people are not maintained in a monarchy. Third question is the government makes amendments in law. In a democracy, the government is formed from the representatives elected by the people for the administration of the country. The government, keeping the constitution in mind, enact necessary laws for the welfare of the people according to the public opinion. If changes in a democracy, then the law enacted and implemented by the government have to change. In a democracy, the government has power to change the law. Thus, the government changed the law. Question number 7 is answer the following question briefly. The first question is why is government required? First point is each country need a government to take the different decision and to implement those decisions. Second point is a government is needed for the performing, implementing and reforming laws according to the constitution. Third point is a government is required to apply laws and rules made by it on all people equally in the country. Fourth point is in a democracy the government is required to run the administration as per the will of the people. It is the government that perform function of the public welfare. In this way the government is required to maintain the peace, law and order and for the administration of the country as well as for the progress of the country. Yahan pe maine thoda niche likha hai, okay? Question number 2 is how many types of government are mostly formed in the world? There are mainly 4 types of government found in the world. Democratic government, communist government, dictatorship government and monarchy. Third question is why it is not possible to administer from one place in India. India is a very vast country and has many diversities. It has 28 states and 8 union territories including the national capital Delhi. Therefore many problems arises in managing the country from one place. Citizens have to suffer difficulties. Thus it is not possible to administer from one place in India. Fourth question is what is the importance of government in a democracy? The importance of government in a democracy. First point is in a democracy the government work by the keeping people at the center. Second point is human rights are protected and preserved in a democratic government. Third point is a democratic government is very important for the all-round development and right of the people. Okay, the fifth question is what can be done if the laws framed by the government are not implemented properly. If the laws framed by the government are not implemented properly and if injustice is done, a voice is raised against it, complaints can be made before the court for the proper implementation of law. The court may be order the government to enforce the law properly. Now question number 8 is write a short note. First is democratic government. In a democratic government people elect a representative by voting. Second point is the government is formed from the member of majority of party from those representatives. Third point is a democratic government takes over the governance of the country on behalf of the people. Fourth point is a final line of the power in this government is in the hand of the people. Fifth point is a democratic government is governed directly or indirectly by the people. Sixth point is a democratic government always protect and preserves human rights. Seventh point is it works for all around development and protection of the rights of the people. Eighth point is in this government election are held at a fixed time. Okay, तो ये चैप्टर की एक्सरसाइज यहाँ पे खत्म होती है. प्लीज़ अगर आपको ये वीडियो पसंद आया तो प्लीज़ लाइक एंड सब्सक्राइब द चैनल. थैंक यू.